Dear students, welcome to Tungal online classes. Today I am going to start with a whole chapter that is reproductive health. What do you mean by reproductive health? Before going to start this chapter, we must understand in the previous chapter we have learnt the reproductive system in human being. So how it is and how it is functioning, all those things that we have studied. And this chapter is also very close related to the third chapter, right? And in this chapter, what we are learning? So simply, we go through this term that is reproductive health. What do you mean by reproductive health? So what is the significance of reproductive health? How it is been achieved? All these are the things that we are learning in this chapter. Okay, then, so in this chapter, what is the meaning of this reproductive health? The question arises. Reproductive health, the term itself says that simply we can say, so healthy sex organs with normal function. So it is the meaning of the term reproductive health. Reproductive health is nothing but reproductively healthy organs or healthy reproductive organs with normal functions. With normal function is the meaning of this reproductive health. But it doesn't have this kind of narrow meaning. It has a vast meaning, or it has a vast perspective or a broader perspective it has. Why? Because it not only includes this meaning, but also includes some of the terms like emotional and social. Emotional and social aspects of reproduction. It shows that it is not a single term that means healthy sex organs with a normal function, but also it gives a broader perspective, broader view to us. So including such kind of words like emotional, social aspects of reproduction. Okay, so that is why WHO has given one particular definition for reproductive health. What is the definition it has given is, so WHO, World Health Organization, has given one definition for this term. What is the definition it gives? Reproductive health means it is total well-being. Total well-being in all aspects of reproduction. In all aspects of reproduction, like, or that is physical, emotional, behavioral and social. See the definition, you will come to know reproductive health is not giving this much meaning only. It has a broader perspective. So it not only includes reproductive health of a single person, it includes the reproductive health of the entire society. Social word indicates behavior, emotional, physical, all these are the terms that makes this term so broader enough, right? So this is the definition which is given by World Health Organization, right? In this chapter, so how to maintain this reproductive health? So how to achieve it, right? So this is the one thing what we are learning. And what is the significance of this reproductive health? So these are the things that we are going to learn now, right? What is the significance? Significance and how to achieve a reproductive health. How to achieve a reproductive health. So these are the things that we are learning in this chapter. Let us go through it now. Reproductive health, its problems and strategies. Let us start with. Reproductive health, problems and strategies. Let us start with. Let us go through the problems first. What are the problems, what are there related to reproductive health? So as to maintain this reproductive health, what kind of problems are we facing? So this is one question. The first problem for all the problems in the entire world itself is overproduction, or it is said to be as overpopulation. Overpopulation is the first problem for everything, right? So that's why, so this is only the population which is under our control can help us to maintain everything. But if it is overpopulation, then it is very difficult to maintain the entire population. And very difficult to maintain the reproductive health in all the people of the population, all the people in the entire world itself, right? So this is the first problem. And next one is child marriages. Child marriages itself is also another problem. In rural areas, usually the people, so they usually implement such kind of child marriages itself. So many of the problems the children are facing due to child marriage itself. All those common problems that you know better, right? So, and the next problem is, what is the next problem? MMR, that is as well as IMR, infant mortality rate and maternal mortality rate. Maternal mortality rate in the sense that the rate of the deaths of the mothers and the rate of the deaths of, mortality stands for death, so death of the infants or the children itself. This is also one more problem, major problem, right? If the reproductive health is not maintained in mothers as well as a child, so that moment what happens, the death of both of themselves that take place. This is also one more challenge, the problem what is there before us, right? Next one. The next one is STDs. What are these STDs? The question arises. Sexually transmitted diseases. If the people do not have any idea related with the sexual intercourse, sexual problems, so or sex related aspects, then certainly, so sex related diseases are transmitted from one person to another person, right? And these are also one more type of problems what we are facing, right? So, and so we have to take care of child as well as the mother, right? So during the period, what kind of period after the birth of the child, we have to take care of both of themselves very much, right? So these are all the problems, the common problems what we come across. And many of the deformities are arising in the children, the one who go for child marriages itself. So all these are the problems we can say, right? And apart from this one, what kind of strategies are there so as to maintain reproductive health, right? So that is also the thing what we must aware of, right? What are the strategies? The strategies related with the reproductive health are, number one, what is the strategy? Already you know, India was the first country, the one who had implemented some of the action plans as well as programs so as to maintain the reproductive health long ago itself, right? Soon after the Indian freedom, so that moment, India implemented some of the strategies related with the reproductive health. So that's why India is the first country, the one who gave the first importance for reproductive health. The entire world, we can say, right? This is one of the NCERT line that you must remember. That is, one of the strategies is family planning. Is one of the best program which has been implemented in the year 1951, right? The first strategy, India is the first country in the world, to implement the action plans and the programs related to reproductive health, like first one, family planning in the year 1951, right? And second one, this family planning was followed by Indian government in those days, and along with this one more most advanced program has been implemented and it has been running nowadays also. That is the program which is named as reproductive and child health care. So it is simply so termed as, or it is abbreviated as RCH. RCH is nowadays, it has been implemented nowadays. So it is been running nowadays, right? Reproductive and child health care is one of the best program which is implemented in India. Right, so which is giving more service to the mother as well as taking care of the child, etc. itself, right, which is giving more importance for reproductive health related to all the entire society, all the people itself, right? So this is one of the important program. So as well as family planning is also one more important program which has been implemented in India so as to bring about the awareness regarding the reproductive health among the people itself. So these are the programs which are implemented in India so as to build awareness amongst the people, right? So these are such kind of strategies which is been meant. And apart from this one, so as to publish such kind of awareness amongst the people, some more ideas have been made by Indian government. So that is nothing but print media is there, social media is there. Through the social media, through the print media, so it has been giving awareness regarding the reproductive health, of course. Reproductive health awareness programs have been made through the social media as well as print media itself. This is also one more strategy. And here the utilization of the mothers especially, right? So that is parents as well as so the teachers as well as the friends or some other group of the people, the one who are utilized in this program so as to bring about some awareness related with so reproductive health. So this is also one more strategy made over here.